as far as integration is concerned, the derivation of formulas is not important for us in physics. If you are able to remember these formulas, that's enough. So the integration of x to the power of n with respect to x is x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. C is integration constant. Why we have to write integration constant for indefinite integral? Because we don't have any limits. If you don't have any limits, you have to write C. If you have limits, you should not write C. Why? I will tell you later. So C is called integration constant. And next, integration 1 by x dx is equal to log x plus C. Integration sin x dx is equal to min x cos x plus C. Integration cos x dx is sin x plus C. Integration secant square x dx is equal to tan x plus C. And integration cosecant square x dx is equal to minus cot x plus C. Integration secant x tan x dx is equal to secant x plus C. Integration cosecant x cot x dx is equal to minus cosecant x plus C. Integration e power x dx is equal to e power x plus C. Integration 1 by root of 1 minus x square dx is equal to sine inverse x plus C. Integration 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to tan inverse x plus C. And here integration 1 by x root of x square minus 1 dx is equal to sine secant inverse plus C. You can observe one thing. Log x differentiation is 1 by x. 1 by x integration is log x. Same way, sin x differentiation is cos x. So cos x integration is sin x. So tan x differentiation with respect to x is secant square x. So secant square x integration with respect to x is tan x. Same way, here also you can go for same. That means integration is reverse operation of differentiation. Let us see some formulas of integration, and the proof of these formulas is not important in physics. If you are able to remember these formulas, then it is enough for us. Here the first formula is integration x power n with respect to x is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c, where n is not equal to minus 1. Here c is called integration constant. Integration 1 by x dx, that means integration of 1 by x with respect to x is equal to log x plus c. Integration of sin x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c. Integration of cos x dx is equal to sin x plus c. Integration of secant square x dx is equal to tan x plus c. Integration of cosecant square x dx is equal to minus cot x plus c. Integration of secant x tan x dx is equal to secant x plus c. Integration of cosecant x cot x dx is equal to minus cosecant x plus c. Integration of e power x dx is equal to e power x plus c. Integration of 1 by root of 1 minus x square dx is equal to sin inverse x plus c. Integration of 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to tan inverse x plus c. Integration of 1 by mod x square root of x square minus 1 dx is equal to secant inverse x plus c. From these formulas, you can observe one thing, that log x differentiation is with respect to x. Log x differentiation with respect to x is 1 by x. So 1 by x integration with respect to x is log x again. So sin x differentiation with respect to x is cos x. And cos x integration with respect to x is sin x again. So you can observe the same thing in all the formulas. That means integration is reverse operation of differentiation. So you write down the formulas of differentiation on one side of the paper and integration formulas on the other side of the paper, and you compare both, and you learn. It is easy for you to remember the formulas. Now my question is, suppose if log x differentiation is 1 by x, 1 by x integration is log x, why you are writing c, that is integration constant? See, here there are no limits, that's why we call it as indefinite integral. For indefinite integral we are going to use this integration constant. Suppose you are having any limits, so we are not going to use any constant directly, we are going to substitute the limits. So for indefinite integral, why you have to write one constant? Let us test it with one example. I am going to explain this, why we have to write this c. Before discussing one example, let us discuss some properties. Integration f of x plus g of x dx is equal to, separately I am going to write, integration f of x dx plus integration g of x dx. Even minus is there, I just write minus. So integration, some constant into f of x dx is equal to, you take constant outside, integration f of x dx. This is what we write. And one more thing is, we don't need right now the integration of product of two functions, f of x into g of x. So it is not much useful in this integration in physics. Whenever it is required, at that time the teachers will teach you. And one more thing, integration f dash x by f of x dx is equal to ln f of x or log f of x plus c, and integration of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx is equal to f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So any function you are having in denominator, just if you have its a differentiation in numerator, then you can write log f of x and f of x whole power n, any function it may be. Suppose sin x power n, sin x differentiation is cos x dx, so sin x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c, that's all. So we are going to write in this way. Suppose if you differentiate some x cube minus 2x square plus some 3. So differentiation of x cube is 3x square minus 2 constant, so I am taking outside of differentiation. X square differentiation is 2x plus 3 is constant, so its differentiation is equal to 0. So what I am going to write, 3x square minus 4x plus 0, that means just minus 4x. Now I am going to integrate it. Integration of reverse operation, whether is it actually reverse operation of differentiation or not, let us see. 3x square minus 4x dx, we know the formula of integration, integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So I am going to answer why we have to write plus c if there is no limit. Why we have to write integration constant, that I am going to answer here. So this is f of x, this is g of x. So integration 3x square dx minus integration 4x dx. So again 3 constant, 3x square dx minus 4 integration x dx, so power 1. So 3 x power n dx is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. instead of n you are having 2. So x power n plus 1, that means 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 minus 4 into x power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1, that means 3 into x cube by 3 minus 4 into x square by 2. What you are going to get? X cube minus 2x square, but we have missed this constant 3. We have missed this constant 3. We got every other term, but we missed the constant. That's why we don't know that constant. Suppose if only this problem is given, so I can't expect that it is 3. That's why I am writing plus c after doing integration. This is the main importance of writing integration constant while solving indefinite integrals. If limit is given, limits are given, then that constant we are going to get after substituting the limits. That's why we don't write a plus c when we go for. That means from the previous problem we understood one thing: integration of f of x dx. Suppose if you are going to get capital F of x, and by differentiating it, d by dx of f of x, so we are going to get small f of x. That means differentiation is reverse operation of integration, or integration is reverse operation of differentiation. Now how to substitute the limits? That is one very important thing. Suppose if you do f of x dx and x limits, first lower limit is a, upper limit is b, and after doing integration, suppose if you get another function, that means capital F of x, and you have to write like this: lower limit x is equal to a here, x is equal to b, upper limit. Now how to substitute limits? First you substitute upper limit, wherever x is there you just write down b. So f of b in the total function minus, you have to write next f of a. So in this way we are going to substitute the limits. Now let us go for one problem. Let us go for one problem. Let us integrate x cube plus some 3 by x minus 1 by root x plus some 3 dx, and the limits of x is from 1 to 3. Let me take. So x cube definite integral with the limits, x cube dx separately I am writing, integration 3 by x minus dx minus 1 by root x. So I can write x to the power of minus 1 by 2 dx plus 3 integration dx. So 3 is constant, you can take outside, and here nothing, x power 0. So 3 is constant, you can take outside. So 1 by x. So for all x is equal to 1 to 3, x is equal to 1 to 3. X is equal to 1 to 3, x is equal to 1 to 3. So x cube integration is x to the power of 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1, and where you have to go for 1 to 3 x value, plus 3 into 1 by x dx is log x, and from 1 to 3 minus x to the power of minus 1 by 2. Integration with respect to x is x to the power of minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Again from 1 to 3 plus 3 x power 0. x power 0 plus 1 by 0 plus 1 means x only. That means integration dx is equal to x, that's all. So again from x is equal to 1 to 3. Now x power 4 by 4 from 1 to 3 plus 3 log x from 1 to 3 minus x power minus 1 by 2 plus 1, so 1 by 2, so root x by minus 1 by 2 plus 1, 1 by 2, so you will be getting 2 root x, 2 root x from 1 to 3 plus 3 x from 1 to 3. So what I told you, wherever x is there, just substitute upper limit first minus lower limit, so by 4, 3 power 4 minus 1 power 4 plus 3 into log 3 minus log 1 minus 2 root 3 minus root 1 plus 3 into 3 minus 1. So you simplify it, you will be getting the answer for this integration. This is the way how to do integration and how to substitute the limits. Now one graph is given, yx graph. It is a straight line. Now we have to calculate area between this graph and x-axis. So I have two methods. The method one is, I am going to divide this region into two parts. That is one rectangle part and another is triangle part. So rectangle area plus triangle area gives you area between this graph, yx graph and x-axis. So total area is equal to, now for rectangle, length into breadth. So length value is 4 minus 2 and breadth is equal to 3. So 4 minus 2 into 3 plus, and triangle area is half into base. Base is 4 minus 2. Height is this one, that means 7 minus 3. What you are going to get? 2 into 3 plus half into 2 into 4. So 6 plus 4, that is equal to 10 units. So another method also I can follow. That is, anyway I am given two points. This point is for 2, 3, I can call it as x1, y1, and this point is 4, 7, I can call it as x2, y2. So I can develop the equation of this straight line. So already I told you, so if you call this point as x comma y, this will be y minus 3 and this will be, suppose this is x, so this will be x minus 2, and from here to here 4 minus 2, from here to here 7 minus 3. So slope is constant, that means y minus 3 by x minus 2 is equal to 7 minus 3 by 4 minus 2. So y minus 3 is equal to x minus 2 into 7 minus 3, 4 by 2, that is equal to 2. So 2x minus 4 plus 3, that is equal to y, y is equal to 2x minus 1. So with x-axis, I am going to calculate the area between f of x graph, that means y is equal to, I am calling it as f of x graph, with x-axis. With x-axis, so I have to take x limits. So I am going to integrate it to calculate the area. Integration f of x dx from where to where? From 2 to 4. So 2 to 4, that is equal to integration 2x minus